Okay, welcome back everyone. I know it's been a while. Life circumstances for me have gone sideways, upside down, backwards, forward. Been having a lot of problems with friends and everything's games crashing. So I'm hopefully going to get through this video and get it out for you. I wanted you to take a look. This was another skin made by my friend. As you can see, I got the snakes on the mud flaps. I got it on the side. I got my name on the stairs. I got it on the grill. And if you look on the door, I got my name on there. Got the snake skin above. Got my co-pilot, Carol. You know, so I wanted to show you this lovely skin, and we're gonna back up, and the trailer's already loaded, so we're gonna hook back into it. W900 Highway Killer by John Ruta, updated. So
time to hit the road.
Pretty much a brand new car. So we're gonna get off and taking a load of flour from El Centro, California to Tonopah, Nevada, going from 80M to the general store, 40,815 pounds, going 534 miles, truck says it will take us 34 minutes. So, let's get underway, have some fun, be back on the channel. Videos, hopefully I can start going, because there's more stuff going on with my personal life that is wrong, but that I'm not going to get into right now.
Never mind, I'll find a new route.
And then it's fixing to change again because of medical accommodations. So where it's going, and everything's up in the air with that right now until they get it all figured out. Of course, I'll be the last to know, so that's how that's gonna work. But anyway, so that's where everything's been. And like I said, everybody that I've dealt with is experiencing multiple game crashes, so hopefully, we won't experience that. This will be a pain in the butt to try to splice and all that good. What's going on there? What's happening here? Really? Y'all had to fork in that line? Holy smokes, we are not going to deal with that. So guess what we're going to do? We're going to cheat a little bit. Yeah, we're going to cheat a little bit because something's going on over here. So we're going to cheat a little bit.
Finding a new route.
Accommodations and everything else. So I am truly sorry that better than what I figured out. And,
go straight on. Son got hit with COVID, I guess. None of us, my grandkids, myself, or my daughter caught it because we've been vaccinated, and if we caught it, we didn't know it and didn't really do anything. And like I said, work is, my schedule changed so dramatically that I was still trying to catch up, and then my accommodation kicked in, so that's, everything's kind of tossing up right now for that. So I want to get this video out. I'm trying to keep it down because people are sleeping in the house. Go straight on.
But I wanted to get a video showcasing the truck.
Straight on.
I've got
go straight on.
And yes, I need to visit a repair shop to get the stuff repaired, but we're going to wait on that until I find one. So I don't know if I'll be going back to Jack's too, staying. Well, Jack's 3 tells me they ain't got nothing there for my accommodation, so. So hopefully I'll move back to singles on Jack's too and be alright, and I'll probably, worst case scenario, I'll have to take a night shift, which is 6:30 at night until 4 in the morning, you know, and then I'll have to reacclimate to that, which is too hard, and then figure out what my days off are, and get my body back in, get my body into that schedule, and then we can, if he could be coming in, and I'm going to try to get the videos done, I can get done. Because when Pete comes in, it'll be Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday at this point, right now. Like I said, that could change with facility change again. Any different, you know, number of things could happen. I mean, I wouldn't mind staying at the facility I'm at and working, I think it's 11 to 9:30 at night, kind of like a midship. I'd love that. But I wanted to get you guys video, but I wanted to make sure I was having stable gameplay first. So far, so good. Knock on wood. Hopefully, this one will be one of those. I think I've moved out. Yep. Get a paid mod for rims, so that's helped out a lot, especially in ruined trucks. Great rims, great tires, but they don't stick in the rain. I did download a different weather program that when it rains, oh, it rains, and it thunders and lightning and everything else. So, you know, hopefully we'll get to hear that. Like I said, this is the updated highway killer that John Rudin just gave out this month, to the last month, I think it's this month, with the 86-inch sleeper, and got my girls on the back, of course, and I had a friend of mine, Bear, did the skin. You know, if you're interested, please let me know. I can set you up with him, and he does great work for, you know, price of something that you and him will have to talk about. But this is a custom paint job that I went up and got the numbers for off of Google, and that's how I painted the truck, and I think it works better than the purple I had on Pika's truck, which I still have, but he did an amazing job on this skin. And blew my mind with it, and he's working on the trailer skin to do the trailer up.
Keep right, and then exit right.
And we'll see how that goes. Because I exit right. One of the maps that I bought, which was Alaska for whatever reason, I get up and around Fairbanks, and there's only certain things I could do in Fairbanks, or the game was crashing. I have a chain mod now for going up into Alaska. I can chain the truck. So when I put Crossy's winner in, we're going to try running Crossy's physics, which has been a no-go for most everybody I know because it makes things super slick. So with chains now, I might be able to run without having too much of an issue.
Turn right.
I don't know why my gas pedal's back to adding to tap to get the Jake in to go. The guy that did the blinker mod, ATS accessories, got a new blinker out, the V3. Oh, I still want to get into that because now the blinker mod will do multiple things like run your windshield wipers, high beams, and you'll still have three switches to program. So, three buttons that you can map. help my box greatly when I get the big box, the big Patriot XL box. It'll alleviate something that I can map to because, well, SES came out with the air ride suspension, which means you can actually lower the front, lower the rear, lower the whole truck, raise it back up, raise it up, put it back to where, you know, center. And people aren't putting that on the boxes yet, so that's going to be a new feature that we can deal with 145. And how that's being utilized is I went and dropped the trailer one time trying to figure out this whole game and went into a place to get fuel. Came back out, went to pick the trailer up, and the game told me I had to lower the air suspension to pick the trailer up. So that was something new. So, cost of everything. And no
keep
exception.
Right, and then exit right. Exit right. Get ready to turn right.
But I'm going to be, like I said, focusing on
turn right.
My personal life. Marriage coming up, you know, for myself, getting married, yay. So, many of you know the situation behind that. My wife has been gone 5 years, it's November, and I think it's about time that she'd want me to go on, so try to make that happen. This is starting to tick me off with the mischief's law. And once that happens, not that I'll be able to devote. Well, I'll be able to devote a little bit more time to doing videos. RV and go cruise and see the United States because she's not from the United States. So probably be gone for, you know, when all that gets set up and ready to go, probably be gone for a couple of weeks, back for a month, gone for another couple of weeks or something like that. She's talking about doing a lot of traveling, so, and she wants me to quit my job. That will actually give me a little bit more time when I'm home to do videos. And, you know, maybe I can work it out to where I'll know when we're going to go out sightseeing again. And I can plan a bunch of videos for that time we're gone. You know, stuff like that. I want to get back into it wholeheartedly. There's a bunch of stuff I'd like to do for my gaming PC, like build a console for the new box. I'm gonna put the shifter on the floor so it's, you know, realistic. Well, if I build a console box, it alleviates a few other things I'd like to get. You know, I'm not gonna PC pedals, the wheel, the base, the shifter, which is just a tad over a grand, then, you know, it's going to wait till I can. So, and right now, this G27 is, you know, 8+ years old, and she's still doing it. The mischiefs ain't the shifter's fault. That's all on me. Taxes last year, things that should have been done that didn't get done that I tried to correct and don't know if they corrected or not. So, you know, I gotta move. I gotta get out of this place because, you know, my fiance is buying a true triple wide, 48 feet long, 80 or 48 feet wide, 80 feet long. So, now trying to find property. She understands that. I thought we have what we call a video date every week, and we talk in between. Like I said, hopefully we can at least start getting you guys some more videos. My faithful subscribers that have been with me for a while now.
Keep left.
And see if we can't get things rolling like we once did. Maybe not as much, because it seemed like y'all were not watching the video like I had hoped. So if I spread them out and get things squared away, get my fiance here and have a little bit more time, maybe I can get into live streaming. The guy I watch normally hasn't been streaming for a while. His life has been chaotic, so it's like everything since COVID has pretty much died down or settled down a lot. It seems like things have kind of gone chaotic, which is good. I mean, we're back to work and getting the country back to where it needs to be. My stepson caught COVID, and me and my grandkids and my daughter, me and my daughter have been vaccinated and boosted, so I don't think we got sick at all. My two youngest granddaughters, vaccinated and they didn't get sick, so. That helps. And I'm gonna try to plan these loads to where I can get you during the day. This one's gonna end up being a little at night. And about 175 miles. Just been, like I said, a lot of it's been trying to keep the game from going oops. We're on 100 mods, so, you know, I've got profiles all split apart with Ruta.
Go straight on.
Trucks. I got all three of his trucks. I got Pingas separated, Dom's separated, and then I've got the YouTube folder that does not have the 900 in it yet. So that's why I'm showcasing this one the way it is. We'll get to putting it in so I can run it off the other profile. Beautiful truck. Now, got the all the lights for heavy haul. So far, I've done a couple. Trying to get this stuff figured out.
Go straight on.
Worked a little bit. I got the headache rack for this one, and he still hasn't put a APU on it like he does the I'm gonna stop there. Interesting, got my stuff fixed, but oh well. But he hasn't put an APU on this thing yet like he does the classic and the Pete. He did, like I said, the cabin's bigger, the sticker's bigger. He's enabled you to take the blinkers off the fenders, which I do like. So right now you can't see them on this side, and you can barely see them on the passenger side. They're behind the, basically the blind spot mirrors, and when I put them on, you can see them in the hood mirrors. I have the dash cam with the GPS on it because the other picture is one that will be forever frozen in time. And I use the big overhead one because it's easier to see for me than the two little small ones. Gotta get a lot of stuff fixed, eyesight, teeth. be afraid to leave a comment on anything that I can answer. Checking this daily for comments, and I know it's not a big channel or anything like that, but going into Bishop, and I don't think I've been to Tonopah yet, so that's why I decided to take this load with y'all. Discover a city, and what my goal is to work north from here, and take you all into Montana. See how that goes. I do have the Halloween mod in, but it's getting kind of iffy on finding Halloween stuff, but the Thanksgiving and the Christmas mod are still really good, but those go in at a different time, so. But as you can see, that he's added a headache rack back there. Bart's trailer, which I won't ever get away from because I think he's got the best trailers. We'll be getting into a new topper. Put this in a box, and then that way if something happens to my other topper, I'll have a topper to use. Like I said, I may be buying another just generic button box because with all the new stuff that's been added, putting my shifter base on the floor is gonna kill 12 buttons. If I get the new steering wheel set up I wanna get, which is just a new wheel and
go straight on
and everything to move it out, there are 6 more buttons I gotta come up with, so I'll buy another generic box that's just buttons so that
keep right,
I can set
and
them,
then turn right.
Label them and know what they're for. And I do believe
turn right.
Check over to this Kenworth dealer here and get the stuff fixed while I can. Oh, see? This is where it happens.